After flying from Belgrade yesterday, the quick 1 hour and 10 minute hop over to Ljubljana, today we're getting another look at an MRO facility under the AviaPrime group. This one is Adria Tehnika. You may remember Adria Airways, the once proud carrier of Slovenia. That is no longer. Some of these buildings, I think, used to belong to them, I'm told. I'm gonna get a look at what they're doing here, various aircraft maintenance. Let's check it out. At this facility, I have an excellent tour guide. He's been here since 1974, so he's seen nearly 50 years of development, and he certainly knows his stuff. We start off with a CRJ in for maintenance. I've never actually seen a CRJ in the hangar before, so this is very interesting.
This one only arrived yesterday morning, so we're still in the opening the panels to prepare for inspections. First, we do the incoming inspections and tests outside the hangar. If needed, then we defuel the airplane and then we put it back inside the hangar. Plus, if needed, we jack it. Depends on the nature of check. And for this case, it obviously needed because we had to remove the gears. We will go to remove the brakes as well to inspect the landing gear. Plus, we also removed the fan blades already to inspect the pins and the bumpers there to prevent engine vibrations in the future. And we've been Bombardier and Mitsubishi authorized service facility since 2002. That's how we started with the third-party maintenance. 100% CRJs, at those times mostly CRJ 100, 200 and 700s. Now the 100s and 200s we rarely see, the 700, 900 and 1000 are now more common.
Is there quite a bit of difference in terms of those older, the 100s, 200s versus the newer?
Yeah, it's fairly different airplane. From the system side, from the structural side, because CRJ 100, 200 was developed from the Challenger, business jets, and the CRJ 700, 800, 900, 1000 were really developed as a regional.
Right.
Plus, it's a real airplane with slots and flaps. And all
that. Yeah.
This facility currently does exclusively CRJ and A320 family maintenance.
I don't think I've ever been under a CRJ before because they tend to be pretty low to the ground. It helps that this one is jacked up. We're just under the wheel wells right now. Quite a different way to check out a CRJ.
It's a nice view down.
Yeah. Yeah.
Here we can see the redundancy of the elevator control with the three actuators on each side, powered by different hydraulic systems. That's for other control as well.
Another very uncommon view to get of an aircraft standing up next to the tail. This will never happen unless you stand up on a platform here in a maintenance hangar. It's what a way to look at a CRJ. Really looks much bigger from up here, actually, than when you see them out on the tarmac or sitting inside one. Adria Tehnika has four hangars at the moment and is currently considering building a fifth hangar, which would increase their capacity a further 50%.
Here it's a struggle to find people, skilled people, for this sort of thing.
It is, but we are trying to hire as many locals as possible and then put them through the basic training for mechanic, then the type training, and in about 5, 6, 7 years we really get the local people that are trained with the company culture in as well. I started here June 3rd, 1974.
Oh wow,
so
okay.
We'll be 50 years next year.
50 years.
I started here as a student part-time, then full-time since March 79.
That is amazing. Wow.
The same building, the same floor. Yeah, and I enjoyed every minute. It was every day something new, interesting. I started with DC-9s, then MD-80s, the Havilland Dash 7s. Then we were a launching customer for A320s. Mm-hmm. We actually took part in the design of the airplane. Mm-hmm. I was involved in the cockpit definition group, in the maintenance program. maintenance steering committee activities to define the maintenance program from the airlines. We learned a lot being involved in that part of the introduction of the airplane in the fleet. And when we received the first A320 back in May 89, it was the serial number 00043. Wow. And now they are delivering, I don't know, 11,500, something like that. But we had to put the A320s through the all the children diseases. I spend more nights here than at home.
These days, the number of CRJs in commercial service is diminishing. Over in the A320 hangar, things are looking a lot busier. This particular A320 is deep into its heavy maintenance check. This is always so fascinating to see.
The air conditioning heat exchanger. Basically, what we are doing here is what the operator on the or the camo gives us, the work orders, the complete package what we have to perform. So here all the panels have been opened already, but it's now in the cleaning phase to be able to inspect the structure for the condition. So the computers are from the front, and these are all the, let's say, backstage with all the wires. And normally we have to do some modifications here. It's a fly-by-wire electrically, but there are some real mechanical wires for the landing gear emergency extension, for the THS control, and for other control. Wow. But this is really for emergency only.
Wow.
Here, majority of the items have been removed, like seats and galleys, the toilets. Toilet is being removed now for the access, because on these big checks, the so-called wet area structure below the wet areas is critical for corrosion.
Oh, yeah.
Below the galleys, below the toilets, because in 6 or 12 years, because there's the inspection interval of 6 years, you always find something.
Yeah. Mm.
To remove all the PSUs. These are the aft toilet units.
It's funny seeing them in the middle of the cabin.
Yeah. We're going to remove the body flex, the NTF, and then all the floor panels for the access to the floor support structures, all the beams there, and normally we have to replace a couple of them. Area, because that's the part of the cabin where the airflow gets out of the passenger cabin and goes down below the.
Wow.
And that's what we need to clean. And that's what dust accumulated over 6 years.
Amazing.
There is a duct for the air conditioning, so the fresh air is coming into the cabin and actually getting in on top, and then the flow goes out below. So there's a constant flow of fresh air.
It's always fun to be on board these aircraft when they've been stripped out. I've had the chance a few times recently. including, of course, the recent Etihad A380. It's gotten great views and a great response, so trying to bring you more of that. And it's, of course, fun for me to see all that goes into not just the structure, the inner workings of these aircraft, but keeping them in tip-top shape, checking for corrosion, making sure everything is working well, and of course all the backup systems that are in place too to keep things very, very safe. This aircraft has been here for 4 days. They've been stripping it of all its parts for this maintenance check, and it'll spend about a month here in total.
Among the thousands of parts needed to make an airplane work, there's also the more mundane pieces to consider, such as flooring. And they've got stocks of that too here, of course. Whatever their customers use, that gets sent over to them, and they stock it here in rolls so they can easily install it once the heavy checks are done with. At Adria Tehnika, they've recently developed the capability to repair what's called the mirror fitting and the pistol fitting, both of which are critical parts in the cockpit windshield structure. During heavy checks, they'll inspect the windshield frames, and if any issue is found, instead of replacing the full part, they can now repair it.
The mirror fitting repair for the A320 cockpit center frame, windshield center frame, and this is the pistol fitting repair on the frame 4. We actually avoid replacing the complete window frame, which is extremely expensive on one side, plus also man hour wise. So we reduce the cost for the customer, plus also the need for the number of sheet metal guys on our side.
It's always just so impressive to see what a massive operation each one of these checks requires.
And then boš pokazal, kako deli ven skačejo.
Finally, have a look at this storage machine that holds over 10,000 mostly very small aircraft parts. Just search for the part needed in the computer and the system delivers it, even helpfully pointing out the precise location in the tray. It saves space and obviously time spent searching as well.
So we would need another one.
Hope you enjoyed this little look at what Adria Tehnika is up to, keeping planes fit for flight and in great shape. Which aircraft hangar do you think we should try and visit next? Let us know in the comments. In Ljubljana for Flight Radar 24, I'm Gabriel Lee.